Hello. Now we will see this topic. Class 12, CBSE Physics, Board Exam Question A 2005. Moving charges and magnetism. From that chapter, we will see this question. Two wires of equal lengths are bent in the form of two loops. One of the loops is wire shaped and the other loop is circular. These are suspended in a uniform magnetic field and the same current is passed through them. Which loop will experience greater torque? Give reasons. Okay, you see how to solve. Two wires of equal length, let's say length is L, length is L. Two wires. Wire 1. Okay. Same for first wire, for second wire. Same length. But you see here, wire shape and the other loop is circular. These are suspended in a uniform magnetic field and then and the same current is passed. So what they have done, two wires, same length, one is bent in the form of a square, the other one is bent in the form of a circle. First they are suspended in a magnetic field and then the current is passed. So when they are suspended in the magnetic field, we assume that theta is 0 in one case, that is both the wires are suspended in such a way that the planes are perpendicular to the magnetic field. Plane of the two wires are perpendicular to the magnetic field. One possibility, the other one they are not perpendicular but having same angle other than 90 degree. Plane. Or in terms of theta, you can say theta is 0 or theta is non-zero. But it is same for both the coils. Let us see. What is theta? Theta is the angle between perpendicular to the plane of the coil at the magnetic field. The formula is accordingly given. So, the formula first of all is tau is equal to I into A cross B or IAB sin theta in scalar. Scalar form, tau is equal to I into A, B sin theta. What is theta? Theta is the angle between perpendicular to the plane of the coil and the magnetic field. That is theta. What is I? Current through the coil, which is same in both coils. What is A? Area of the coil, which will definitely differ because length is same and the shapes are different. What is B? Same magnetic field in both the coils. So first to find area. Okay. So first coil, let's say it is square shaped. This is square. This is circular. Okay. So square will find area. So this is square. Total length of the square, circumference or total length, or you can say the perimeter of the square will be L. So each side will be L by 4. So what is the area for this A1? L by 4 square. L squared by 4. Now come to this. This is for square. For circular, we see what happens. L is equal to 2 pi r, which gives you r is equal to L by 2 pi. What is the circumference? What is the area of the circle? Pi r square. Pi r square, L squared by 4 pi square. You can cancel 1 pi, you get L squared by 4 pi. See area. Area 1, L squared by 16, I am sorry, L squared by 16, not 14, 16. That is L squared by 4 pi. You can easily check
A1 is 16, this is less than 16. This is less than 16 means A2 should be greater. A2 greater than A1. Because pi is 3 point etc. 3 point something. It being irrational, non-terminating digits will come. But anyhow, it can't be equal to 4. So, 4 multiplied by 3 point, so many digits following, but never be equal to 4. So, we can say that denominator is less than 16. Here it is 16, here it is less than 16. So, we can say A2 greater than A. So, you come to this, tau. For the first one, A2, assuming theta is non-zero first, but it is same for both. Theta means what? As the coil is suspended, you see that the coil is suspended. It's a coil, it's a magnetic field. Initially, let's say the coil is suspended like this. Square also like this, circular also. So theta not zero. Theta is not zero, and same for both. I same, B same. Greater A will give greater tau, assuming theta same, but not zero. So assuming theta same for both square and circular, A2 being greater than A1, we get tau 2 is greater than tau 1. Tau 2 means for circular. So the circular loop will experience greater tau. Again I repeat, for this theta should not be equal to 0. Theta is equal to 0 means whatever be the area, torque will be same, which is 0. Torque will be 0 when plane of the area is perpendicular to the magnetic field or perpendicular to the coil is along the magnetic field. But theta is defined as the angle between perpendicular to the plane of the coil and the magnetic field. So theta 0, that be the case, whatever be the area, torque will be zero. So it's better to discuss both possibilities. What are the both possibilities? Theta 0 for both circular square, theta non-zero for both circular and square. But we have to assume whatever be the value of theta, it is same for both the coils, circular as well as square. So what is the final answer? Tau 2 is greater than tau 1, provided theta is not 0. Tau 2 is equal to tau 1 is equal to 0, then theta is. Understood that?